Hi, in previous video, we learned how to solve quadratic equation by completing the square. Today, we are going to learn how to solve a quadratic equation by factorization method. For this, we are going to need a question. Let the question be 6x square plus 5x minus 6 equals to 0. This equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, where a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant. To be able to solve a quadratic equation by factorization, we need to look at a, which is the coefficient of x square, at b, which is the coefficient of x, and at c, which is the constant term. Here, a equals to 6, b equals to 5, and c equals to minus 6. Now, the very first thing we do is find out the value of AC. Here, AC equals to 6 times minus 6 equals to minus 36. And B is 5 as said earlier. Now, we need to find two numbers whose sum will be equal to B, that is to 5, and whose product will be equal to AC, that is to minus 36. How can we do it? For this, we need to factorize AC or 36 and find two factors whose sum will be 5 and product will be minus 36. Let's do it. 36 can be written as 1 times 36. So 1 and 36 will be one set of factors for 36. Let's see if this works. To get the product to be minus 36, we can make one of these factors negative by adding a minus sign to it. So, we can do a plus 1 and minus 36 or minus 1 and plus 36. But none among these numbers will give us a 5 upon adding. That is to say, the numbers in set 1 are 1 and 36. Here, 1 added to minus 36 will give us a 1 plus minus 36 equals to 1 minus 36 equals to minus 35, which is not a 5. Again, the numbers in set 2 are minus 1 and plus 36. These numbers, when added together, will give a minus 1 plus 36 equals to 35, which is again not 5. So, these sets of factors didn't work. So, let's try and get another set of factors. Since 36 also equals 2 times 18, these can also be the factors. Let's see if this will work. So, although we can get 2 and 18 to give us a minus 36 by either making 1 among 2 and 18 negative, there is no way we can get their sum to be 5, as minus 2 plus 18 will give us a 16 and plus 2 minus 18 will give us a minus 16. So, this didn't work either. Let's move on to another set of factors. It can be 3 times 12. Just look at this. Even this won't work, as we cannot use a 3 and 12 to be 5 when added, even if we put a negative sign to one of them. Let's find out another set of factors then. It can be 4 and 9. Will it work? Let's see. To get minus 36, we can put a minus sign to any one of them. What will happen if we put the minus sign to 9? Minus 9 times 4 will give us a minus 36, but minus 9 added to 4 will give us a minus 5. Our requirement here is to get a plus 5. So, let's do the other way around. Let's put the minus sign to 4 and let 9 be as it is. As for the product, minus 4 times 9 will give us a minus 36. Let's look onto the sum. 9 added to minus 4 will give us a 5. And here we are. We have found out our factors. Now, our work is to write 5 as 9 minus 4 and let everything else to be as they are for this step. It means we are required to write it this way. 6x square plus 9 minus 4x minus 6 equals to 0. Now, we'll expand this expression and it will take the form 6x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 6 equals to 0. Now, we take the initial two terms and factorize them. In maths, a term is a set of numbers and variables multiplied together. Here, 6x square is a term, so is 9x, so is 4x, and so is 6. And an expression is a group of terms separated by plus or minus signs. Here, 6x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 6 is an expression. So, we take the initial two terms of this expression and factorize them. Factorizing is the way of writing an expression as a product of its factors using brackets. For that, let's take common factors from the first two terms and write them outside bracket. Here, we can see that the first term has a 6 and the second term has a 9. So, both of these have 3 in common. And apart from 3, they also have x in common. So, we take 3x common from the first two terms and write this outside the bracket and then write whatever remains in the bracket. We see that after 3x has been extracted from 6x square, what remains in the first term is 2x. It is because 2x when multiplied with 3x gives 6x square. So, there will be a 2x and plus will be as it is. As for the 9x, 3x has been extracted from it. So, what remains is 3. It is because 3x when multiplied by 3 gives a 9x. So, we write 3. Now, we close the bracket as we have been doing two terms at a time. Let's now move on to the third and the fourth term. It involves a minus 4x and a minus 6. We can see that both these terms have a minus in them. We can take minus common and then there is also plus 2 common, so we write 2 outside bracket. Now, whatever remains, we have got to write it inside of the bracket. In third term, what remains is a 2x. It is because minus 2 when multiplied by 2x gives minus 4x. So, we write a 2x and then we write a plus here because the minus has already been taken common. Then, we write 3, which is what remains from the fourth term. So, we now have 3x, 2x plus 3, minus 2, 2x plus 3 equals to 0. Here, we can see two terms. First one is 3x, 2x plus 3, and second one is 2, 2x plus 3. Both of these have a 2x plus 3 in them. So, we again factorize these terms and take commons outside bracket. And this gives us 2x plus 3, 3x minus 2 equals to 0. Now, when two expressions are multiplied giving result equal to 0, it means at least one of them is a 0. Therefore, looking at this expression, we have to say that one among 2x plus 3 and 3x minus 2 has to be 0. Our work now is to equate both these factors 2x plus 3 and 3x minus 2 with 0. So, 2x plus 3 when equated to 0 will be 2x plus 3 equals to 0 and 3x minus 2 when equated to 0 will be 3x minus 2 equals to 0. 2x plus 3 equals to 0 will give us 2x equals to minus 3 or x equals to minus 3 by 2. Similarly, 3x minus 2 equals to 0 will give us 3x equals to 2 or x equals to 2 by 3. And we have solved the equation by factorization method. Like and subscribe for more videos. Do make a comment if you'd like to see a video on a particular topic.